Hi, welcome to chemmasters.online and get mobile app chemmasters from Google Play stores and get registration on it to get more sample videos and join a course on CSIR net chemical sciences or gate chemistry if you are interested. Thank you. Now we are discussing on gate previous year solved problems. Just look at the given problem. We have given with manganese MnCr2 chromium with O4. Okay, MnCr2O4. So by observing it, we can see that the given complex is simply a spinel. Okay, the given structure is a spinel structure, right? And here we have given with options A. MnCr2O4 is normal spinel with total crystal field stabilization energy of minus 15.5 dq. And option B, inverse spinel with total crystal field stabilization energy of minus 15.5 dq. And if you observe option C, normal spinel with total crystal field stabilization energy of minus 24 dq. And if you observe option D, inverse spinel with total crystal field stabilization energy of minus 24 dq. Okay, so we need to find the given spinel is normal spinel or inverse spinel with crystal field total crystal field stabilization energy. Okay, that may be minus 15.5 dq or minus 24 dq. Okay, right. Now just consider the general formula of spinel. If you observe the general formula of spinel by taking AB, so in the place of AB we have transition metals or non-transition metals. Okay, that means if a metal with plus 2 oxidation state, if a metal with plus 2 oxidation state and if it occupy tetrahedral void, okay, if the metal with plus 2 oxidation state and if it completely occupy tetrahedral void of spinel structure, okay, then and consider B. Okay, consider B now. The metal with plus 3 oxidation state, okay, and if it occupy octahedral void, okay, if the metal with plus 3 oxidation state and completely occupy in octahedral void of the spinel, then that arrangement of the spinel is considered as normal spinel. Okay, just remember those points, those general points of spinels. Now if half of the plus 3 oxidation containing metals occupy tetrahedral void, okay, that means half of the plus 3 oxidation state containing metals occupy tetrahedral void and octahedral void. Okay, and if plus 2 oxidation containing metals completely occupy in octahedral void of the spinel. Okay, so what is just happened here? Plus 3 oxidation containing metals are just sharing octahedral void and tetrahedral void equally. Okay, and that means they are just kicking the plus 2 metals from the tetrahedral voids completely into octahedral void. Okay, so if this kind of arrangement is there in spinel, we consider it as inverse spinel. Okay, we consider it as inverse spinel. Right, now just consider the given spinel here, MnCr2O4. And if you observe for Mn plus 2, manganese plus 2, by the loss of plus 2 electrons, manganese gets its d5 electronic configuration. Okay, and for d5 electronic configuration of manganese plus 2, if we observe octahedral crystal field stabilization energy, okay, and just observe octahedral splitting of d5 of Mn plus 2, and here in the spinels oxygen, okay, in the spinels oxygen is a ligand That means it is a weak field ligand. Okay, so that's why it gives high spin complexes of spinels. Majorly, all the spinels are high spin complexes, except some spinels are there. We need to calculate that means crystal field stimulation energy in strong field effect. Okay, for example, cobalt plus 3 complexes. For cobalt plus 3 complexes, we need to calculate crystal field stimulation energy for octahedrals in strong field ligand effects. Okay, for those cobalt plus 3 complexes, exceptions are also there. That means for cobalt plus 3 complexes with fluorine, okay, and fluorine with water, then we need to calculate as general as these spinels. Okay, right. That means in normally or generally, the calculation of crystal field stimulation energy for octahedral or tetrahedral spinels is through the high spin complexes, or by considering oxygen as low spin ligand. Sorry, oxygen as weak field ligand. Okay, just observe carefully here. And after that, so by considering oxygen as weak field ligand, the splitting, octahedral splitting as like this, so in which the 5 electrons are arranged as in T2G 3 electrons and in EG 2 electrons. Okay, and just check the formula of crystal field stimulation energy. So that is minus 0.4 into T2G plus 0.6 into EG delta 0 plus P, pairing energy. So here the pairing energy is not necessary to give the calculations of spinels. Okay, right. And just substitute the electrons in T2G. So in T2G we have 3 electrons, hence 3 here, and 2 electrons in EG, so here 2. Okay, so total is equals to 0. That means the octahedral d5 mn plus 2 crystal field stabilization energy is 0. Okay, and if you calculate that in tetrahedral tetrahedral complex of mn plus 2 d5, okay, so just like this, the tetrahedral splitting is like this, in which EG has 2 electrons and T2G has 3 electrons. And for tetrahedral crystal field stimulation energy formula is minus 0.6 into EG plus 0.4 into T2G. Just substitute the number of electrons in EG and T2G, we get 0 crystal field stimulation energy for Mn plus 2 D5 tetrahedral complexes. Okay, right. Now check for chromium plus 3. And chromium plus 3 has D3 electrons because by losing of 3 electrons. And if you consider octahedral chromium plus 3 with D3 electronic configuration here, okay, or D3 configuration, and if you observe it, the splitting is just like this. In T2G 3 electrons are arranged. Okay, and by considering crystal field stimulation energy minus 0.4 into T2G. In T2G we have 3 electrons, hence, and in EG 0 electrons, so that is equals to 0, and we get minus 0.4 into 3 equals to minus 1.2 delta 0. Okay, right. And if you observe for tetrahedral chromium plus 3, in tetrahedral chromium plus 3, so the splitting, energy level splitting is just like this. So in EG level we have 2 electrons, in T2G we have 1 electron. So this all splitting is based on weak field oxygen ligand. Okay, right. So that's why high spin electrons are entering into the higher energy level without pairing in the lower energy level. Okay, right. Now, and if you observe crystal field stimulation energy for tetrahedral chromium plus 3 D3 electronic configuration, we have minus 0.2 delta 0. Okay, and now after doing all these calculations, just observe crystal field stabilization energies. In octahedral forms, if you observe, chromium plus 3 has more energy, okay, more crystal field stabilization energy, because Mn plus 2 has 0 crystal field stabilization energy. So by this we can say that By having more crystal field stabilization energy, so it can attain octahedral void of the spinel. Okay, the metal with more crystal field stabilization energy can take its arrangement in octahedral void. Okay, so this is the prime point. Okay, so by that we can say chromium plus 3 all can enter into octahedral void, and then membrane plus 2 takes their position in tetrahedral void. Okay, so by this we can say that the given spinel is normal spinel. Okay, right, and we have calculated for tetrahedral also here. And if you observe for chromium plus 3, a tetrahedral, so tetrahedral value is 0.2 delta 0. Okay, but octahedral crystal field stabilization energy of chromium plus 3 is 1.2 delta 0. So that's why it has octahedral arrangement, octahedral chromium plus 3 has higher crystal field stabilization energy. Hence, this one takes place, chromium plus 3 completely takes place in octahedral void of the spinel. Okay, so that's why it is becoming normal spinel. But if for generally tetrahedral chromium plus 3, if tetrahedral chromium complex has more crystal field stabilization energy than octahedral complex of chromium, then what happens? Simply half of the chromium plus 3 chromium complex is not plus 3 here, just consider different oxidation state. Chromium complex can enter into tetrahedral void and half occupied in octahedral void, and total plus 2 then enter into octahedral void. That means if the plus 3 oxidation containing metal has more crystal phase stabilization energy in tetrahedral form, okay, as tetrahedral splitting arrangement, then inverse spinel is possible. Okay, right, so that is extra points, those are extra points. Now for this information, by this information we can say that the given spinel is normal spinel. Okay, right, next what we need to calculate, the total crystal field stabilization energy. And here for this normal spinel, just consider the tetrahedral void of the spinel is having only Mn plus 2. Okay, for this Mn plus 2, we have calculated the crystal field stabilization energy as 0. That means its count is not needed. Okay, 0 is not counted into total crystal field stabilization energy of given normal MnCr2O4 spinel. Okay, right. Now consider chromium. So, in chromium plus 3, the most stable is that means containing octahedral one, so 1.2 delta 0, that is the total chromiums are taking their place in B position, that means octahedral voids. Okay, so hence we need to consider only octahedral chromium plus 3 with their D3 configuration. Okay, and here we have two chromiums. For one chromium we have 1.2 delta 0, for two chromiums we have 2.4 delta 0. Okay, so by converting delta 0 into dq, so we get minus 24 dq. Okay, so this is the total spinel, that means total crystal field stabilization energy of the given normal MnCr2O4 spinel. Okay, so by analyzing all this, we can say option C, that is normal spinel with total crystal field stabilization energy minus 24 dq, is the correct answer. Okay, right, thank you.